Today we're checking out the future within MIDI controller, so let's go!
Hi, I'm Max Hayes from the band Psyckadeli. Today we are having a look at a MIDI controller from a company called MPMidi. They make a very interesting MIDI controller as I understand, and I've been dying to check it out for a while. But first, let me tell you a little bit about myself. I'm a guitar player, songwriter, recording engineer, and music video creator. I have basically done recording since I started to play guitar. I started with a 4-track going to an 8-track, but now I use Logic Pro X. I've always had some sort of DAW controller running with my recording software to get a little bit more hands-on feeling and not having to do everything with the mouth. And lately, getting more into music productions, I bought a lot of effects and software synths. So when I saw the control surface from MPMidi, it was like a dream come true. This unit seems limitless to what you can do with it. I've watched some videos about it on YouTube, and I've gone to the MPMidi webpage and seen some really fascinating stuff. So it's going to be cool to finally be able to try it out. Here is some footage from when I got the box in the mail. The unit is well packed and has got some nice foam in the box. It's a good fit around the unit. This controller has got some nice weight to it, and the rotor encoder feels really nice, and it has an overall quality feeling to it. The controller's touch monitor is like an extra monitor for your Mac and PC. Therefore, I now need to hook it up to an HDMI port on the back of my Mac and also power it via a USB port. Even though the MP controller is not a DAW controller, I'm going to have more use of the MP controller controlling the software effects that I use in Logic Pro. So let's make a little bit of magic. So here it is set up. MPMidi's got great manuals online on how to hook it up to your computer and also how to install the host plugin. So I feel that I don't have to cover that in this video. Another thing to mention is that the MP host plugin adds zero latency and consume almost zero CPU on your computer. After installing everything, we open up Logic Pro X. Here we can see that we now have the MP multi-host and MP single host. We start by opening the single host. This opens up a window where we will select control and display. Now you will see that something happens on our touchscreen. We can choose the button Show Plugin List or right click on the screen and choose Show Plugin List from here. Now we get a list with all our plugins. So let's go ahead and set up a plugin. Let's do the Ampeg SVT VR as an example. We start by typing in Ampeg in the search window. I choose UAD Ampeg SVT VR and I choose the VST version. Here we have a bass amp with knobs and switches. There are two ways to set up the knobs and switcher. To link an encoder with the first way, you click on the Link Encoder button first, then click or move the parameters that you want to control. Then click on any of the virtual encoders on the screen. This is it. Now it's linked. Now you can just repeat this process, or you can use a second way of linking an encoder with the link multiple. For this, we need to turn on the encoder options. When you press the button up on the left, you get all the information about the encoders. Now you can see the encoder number for all the encoders. We previously used the encoder 25 to do the channel 2 bass, but now we're going to do all the knobs at the same time. So we hit the link multiple button. We get a list on the side, then we choose all the buttons starting from the right. After selecting it all, then just hit the link multiple button again. We wanted the encoder to start from encoder 25, so we write 25 and hit OK. So now we link all the knobs in a row. Now we want to save this. I will go up to Save As, and here I will use the effect folder to save this plugin. Just give it a name and save it. The linking of the parameters only needs to be done once for each plugin. We can also give the plugin its own background. Just drag a picture from another folder and drop it onto the screen. Then save the plugin again. A great feature is that you can add a color to each encoder by clicking over the encoder and selecting a color for that encoder. You can also hide all the encoders by pressing the Hide Encoder buttons. Then you will only see the names of the encoders on the screen. I mostly use plugins from Universal Audio, FabFilter and Plugin Alliance. If you want to be able to use the pre-made presets that come with a plugin. For the UAD plugin that we just did, we will just go to the three dots and click. Here you can choose the setting to load. If I bring up the Better Maker plugin, we now have the buttons for the VST3 presets here. So just choose what presets you want. For the FabFilter plugin, I would just choose the preset setup in the plugin like I have always done, and the encoder follows the new settings in the plugin. So now, only your imagination is the limit for how you want to set up your plugin. Each plugin has got 4 pages of encoders you can set up. As you can see here, when I set up the Ampeg SVT3 Pro plugin, I used the first page to set up all the knobs and buttons, but I used the second page to set up the graphic equalizer. You can choose a different background for each page in the plugin as well. So far we have just used the MP single host for our plugin, but it gets a bit confusing that it only says MPH single in our channel strip. There is a way to get the name for the plugin and also a faster way to bring up the plugin. We will open up the show preset and then choose the Ampeg plugin that we just did. I have added a folder called UAMPMidi. This folder will show up in our plugin list in Logic Pro, so I wanted it to have another name than effects. I will now choose the UAMPMidi and then choose Create Plugins. I will save the amp plugins in the UAMPMidi folder. Now I have created a plugin that will show up in Logic Pro and show the plugin names in the channel strip. I now need to close Logic Pro and then open it up again. Logic will find a new plugin and then add it to our list. This is how it looks. The new plugin will have the letter M before the name of the plugin, and if you want to change that, then you go to the Plugin Manager in Logic Pro. You go to the UAMPMidi list and here you can type in a custom name. That name will show up in the channel strip. Looking at the second host plugin, the MP Multihost, this one is set up like having a plugin effect rack. You choose what plugins you want by clicking over No Plugin Loaded. Go to the touchscreen, choose your plugin from the show presets, and then add your plugin. You can then add more plugins to your list, and if you want, you can save it to later if you use the same plugins on drums, for example. So, this is just another way to setting up your plugins in the channel strip, so try the two ways out and find out whatever way works best for you. So as you can see, the MPMidi controller has got some great features. I'm looking forward to using it even more on my future mixing and sound project and integrating it more and more in my workflow. If you have any questions about the controller, then feel free to get in touch with the people at MPMidi at their website. And as I always says, use it for good, not for evil.